Bundy's Garage, Bundy here. Hey, I'm with Chris Nosalek with Electron Automotive in, what is this, Orange, right?
Yeah. Orange, California.
Orange, California. What do you think is a better car, the Toyota Prius or the Honda hybrids?
So I'm going to be referring to maybe 2013 and older. The newer ones are still under warranty. We don't have much as much experience, so I can't give as good of an answer. But in the older generations, unquestionably, Prius.
Hands down.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Toyota is a great company.
Yeah. Yeah.
They are great.
So they're the only ones that are getting hybrids right every time. Okay. There are very few that are, maybe not even any, that are lemons, where other companies have specific models that you want to stay away from.
Like who?
Honda.
You want to stay away from Honda?
Yeah, as for their older technology, if you're buying older cars, the newer ones, I don't have enough experience to say.
Okay.
But I can comfortably say up until at least 2012, they had a lot of problems with the batteries. Yeah, from our experience, what we've seen is the vehicle kills the battery. So Panasonic produced a great battery for the car, but the car kills the battery under the operating conditions. So Toyota issued a recall or a TSB where they reprogram it, and from what I've noticed it, and it's all over the internet too, you get decreased power, decreased fuel economy, and you get longer battery life, but that's because it's not relying on the battery as much. So their solution to it was a software fix, and I've never seen a software fix that resolves the mechanical issue. So when people get one with a bad battery, there's three routes they go. Scrap it. They buy a cheap battery off of the internet that works, but the car kills it quickly. And you're in a perpetual cycle of whack-a-mole, you know, replacing cells or, you know, replacing the battery all in all. The third option is to go with a quality battery, one that's in very good prime condition that can withstand the abuse, not through the 10 years as it was initially rated, a shorter time, but you can get up to 6 years out of a quality battery.
Okay. And that has to do with what you're doing across the street, making sure they're all good all together.
Yes. Yeah, there's a lot that goes into testing the hybrid batteries.
I forget the name you called it.
Matching?
Matching.
Yes.
Matching.
That's the most difficult part of the process. A lot of people see batteries as good and bad. They'll test voltage, capacity, load test, and all those tests come back and they say, I've got a great battery, they put it in. But there's much more to it than that. There's a lot more to the story. There's a lot of other things. We have about 11 different parameters we need to test. And if any one of those are bad, the whole battery is going to go out. It's kind of like somebody who has great vital signs, except their blood pressure is extremely low. You know, they'll go into a coma and die based off of one problem. Same thing with batteries. You got to test all these different things, and if just one of them is out, the whole thing's going to go down.
Yeah, and Chris made up the systems for this, the testing device and software systems to be able to do that, and I don't think anybody else has the technology.
Yeah, not that we've seen. My biggest challenge in the industry has been remanufacturing the hybrid batteries. There's a lot that goes into it. And it took a lot of R&D to finally get it down. Nobody makes proper equipment to thoroughly test the batteries. We had to do all the research, the engineering, the manufacturing our own.
That's amazing, dude.
To have the machines to do it. Yeah, and now that we have it, man, it's so much easier, so much faster, so much more reliable.
Do you see yourself making more machines?
Oh, absolutely. They're in production as we speak, so.
Okay, you're making them right now.
Yeah, I personally am not. I've got other engineers building them and even making better and better revisions. The machines that we're using, we get input from our techs to say, hey, we really love A and B, but C and D are a little difficult. So the next revision, you know, we change things on.
You just need to come up with a computer that can talk to Tesla vehicles.
Yeah. Yeah. Tesla.